Father, Father, and veteran into the gospel. He's going to come and he's going to put on the speaker. No better person than him to present the speaker.
Praise
no
the Lord.
No other person than our Father, Bishop Christie. Let's greet him with a praise the Lord. Come on now, I praise the Lord. Come on now, I praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And Alvaranga and all the other elders, and the Christie, the missionaries, the saints, everybody. I greet you all in Jesus' name. It's a pleasure to be here to worship the Lord with you. We are on the same route heading for the celestial city. And we just got to bear up one another's hands against the wiles of the enemy. But we trust that the God that have called us, he is well able to see us through. We don't have to worry about what the devil is doing. He will always be doing. But we have a God that never fails. Praise him. Praise him.
Praise the Lord
Jesus. Praise the Lord Jesus. God has done so much, I was thinking seriously that I have a lot of things to give God thanks for.
Amen.
And I give God thanks to live, to see my 81st birthday.
Hallelujah!
I spent all the years of my 20s, my 30s, my 40s, and all these years in the church. And I was laying in my bed and I think carefully that if it hadn't been God, I would not have made it.
Amen.
So I don't need a church to ask me to praise God.
Amen.
I will look up to the ceiling of my house and I see God's glory. And I found out that I came from very poor parentage. And God blesses me until I can find food, shelter, transportation. And when I check it all over, I learn. You don't even have to pray to God to bless people.
Amen.
Just tell them to serve God.
Yes.
And God will bless them.
Yes.
Because sometimes we spend too much a long time.
Yes.
Praying for God to bless people. And when you leave, listen, I talk praying now and then because I'm old now.
Yes.
All the prayer I pray for God bless you. You know, I get no blessing.
Amen, amen.
All you need is to go serve God. And automatically, the blessing will flow. Don't play no general. Don't play no hypocrite. Don't pretend that before. Be genuine.
Yes.
And I'm talking to everybody because you have a whole lot of bishops and elders, name them. They're not genuine. Time is in the church. I know a genuine Christian. Genuine Christian is kind, is loving, full of hospitality. Considerate. I was saying to somebody, I come to this conclusion. I would not want to live with some of you.
Amen.
For some of you, live with you.
Amen.
Devil.
But you look all right in the church.
Amen.
But you die young, you're
devil. Amen.
You must start the food. controversy. At this time I bring to you my son.
Bless the Lord.
Who God has anointed. And now I'm pleased with an anointing because it reminds me when I was his age and her age, how I was anointed. And I was telling somebody that in the church of the past, I have gone seeing service where no preacher preach. Amen. The power of God falls. Yes. People baptized. Yes. People get the word. Yes. People get knocked out. Yes. And whenever you start to say, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. No! The 90 was in the church. Yes. And we lock a 90. The anointing was in the church. People, we're not seeing people falling on the walk floor. And we have too much a nice place. It was rough stone. But when the Holy Ghost, I said Holy Ghost, when the Holy Ghost move, people roll. Saint Elizabeth and Red Dirt and service over and all them ladies and sisters are dressed in white, but nobody no care about that. The anointing. Let us say the anointing.
The anointing.
God bless you at this time. I present to you a love in Jesus. Give God a praise. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Just give him a praise. Give him a praise. Amen. We want everything. Let everything that have breath to give him praise. Just say praise the Lord in the person next to you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise him with meaning, with feeling, with connection, and emotion. We must feel your praise. It's the anointing that destroys Akash. This is an apostolic church. So we are not afraid to praise him. We're gonna read because I hear Bishop already start preaching. Amen. Amen. We're going to take our text, the team text, which is from Revelation chapter 3. Because we ain't playing tonight, we come to it's too late to play. Amen. We're going to read from Revelation chapter
3 and I think the read the second verse. Amen. From the second verse. It said, be careful, be watchful, and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die. For I have not found your works perfect before God. I like to read it thirdly. Remember therefore how you have received and heard and hold fast and repent. If therefore you shall not watch, I will come on you as a thief, and you shall know what hour I will come unto you. Also, we're going to read from Romans 13, verse 11 and 12. And that knowing the time, that is now, it is a high time to awake out of sleep. For now is your salvation nearer than when we believe. The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. And I think we have another scripture. First Thessalonians chapter 5. Because I want to read them that you know is the word of God. It only says the elder said. Because some people, when they want to refuse, they say, the elder says it. Or it's pastor says it. Amen. Somebody read it from 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 6. It said, therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. Amen. We let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your love, your mercies towards us. Had not been your mercies, we would have died. But because of your grace and your mercy, we ask, O God, that you touch this vessel. Let everything that is spoken tonight be from you. Take all flesh out of the way and let your spirit speak. O God, let your people be edified. Take away pride. Take away vainglory. And you do your work yourself. In Jesus' name. Amen. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. You may be seated. I just want to greet the host pastor, Pastor Alvaranga, and his wife, Elder Jackson, and his wife, my pastor, Bishop George Christie. And Pastor Green, next name is Dakers. I think I see Elder Dakers here. Amen. And evangelist, baby. Thank you. Good to have the woman coming to support.
Amen. Amen.
You see, that means we are awake. So
So it's not a woman thing or a man thing. God, the Bible says that we are all sons. So Jesus knew what he was doing. So you don't have no discrimination. Is him. So put everybody in the same category. Amen. Elder Gail, it's good to have him. And all the Brotherhood president, Minister Miller. Amen. And we have Evangelist Pinnock and all the officers. Who are the core of officers we have? Amen. Down there. We greet you all in the name of Jesus. And the saints and friends, give God the praise. Amen. You see, sometimes we, if we don't call names, people get edgy. Oh, but your name is written in glory. As long as your name is written in glory, you may not call my name down here. But if it's written in the book of the Lamb's book of life, oh Lord. I think Jesus said that to his disciples. Don't be glorious because you demons subject to you. But rejoice because your name. So I'm not an issue if you don't call my name. Yes. Yes.
That's right.
Amen. 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 Bless Lord. We have a topic here. I see some stuff. Things that maybe some of you can take it, but and Jesus says, and the Spirit says, and talk about Revelation, the seven spirits, and that represent the Holy Ghost. And we notice they're talking about Sardis, that church. Sardis, Revelation chapter 3. And what we look at is Sardis was a church, vibrant church. Amen. It was a church where everybody wanted to be. It was a holy church. Church of the living God. Spiritual church. But notice that they have a reputation of doing good in the community. They were charitable. They were hard workers in the vineyard. But something cut across them. So the Bible says, according to verse 2, if I should jump up to verse 1, I love this clause, it said, I know your works, that you have a name. That you live and are dead. Right? So you are alive, but you're dead. You just have the name. And if we should say today that many people are just using the name. So I said, be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die. For I have not found your works perfect before God. You're doing a work, but it's not perfect. I hear Paul spoke in one clause. He said, when God says, I have somewhat against you because you have lost your first love. Many of us, we could put along ourselves beside this church, the Church of Sardis. We were vibrant. We were full of power. But because of, we would call it, and I'm making it plain, because vain glory, selfishness, we have lost out on the purpose of the church. Because the church has a purpose. And I think Paul says, whatever you do in words or deeds, you must do all in the name of Jesus. So you must do things to the glory of God and not as men pleasers. Because the minute you start to please men, you move away from God. So they were working for God until self gets in the way. And the Holy Ghost, I was saying, Holy Ghost, give me something, I want something that day. I have not yet munched. And it was just in the wee hours this morning that the Spirit of God said to me that the minute you leave from the Spirit, Paul mentioned about who have bewitched you. Oh foolish Galatians, that you begun in the Spirit, but now made perfect in the flesh. And a word jumped at me.
Jesus.
We're in a time when we become most people who had the Spirit lost it. So, and when you lost the Holy Ghost, you have to get a substitute. The word synthetic came out at me. Synthetic. They have nowadays synthetic preachers. spiritual. When jump out and remember,
my God,
when you used to have the power, and when you didn't, it was not about notes.
God.
It was not about keys. It was about the Holy Ghost. Take up a song. It was about the Holy Ghost that pick up the preacher.
Inside is a place where they
anointing was. You're shouting, but you're dead. And what we are finding out now, that most of us, what we have in common, it's only the baptism in Jesus' name. But we are walking dead. You see the baptism, he could smoke and drink. And after it over, him upon the choir.
Amen.
Saturday night all night, and then Sunday, dress up, look sophisticated. It's beyond dressing. Now to be awake
out of your sleep.
Wake up time. Yeah. Sometimes folks sleeping and you wake them and you say, me wake. But they're still a stagger. Yeah. When a person fully awake, you're standing upright. When you're drunk, you stop. And sometimes drunken man talk something. It's when them feel sweet. Just stop there under another influence. And sometimes we're under the influence of another spirit.